Welcome to Big Brother Still Brother Space 69. The time is 7:32. Coming up on tonight's show, we go in search of the perfect woman with John McCurick. It is a marriage made in heaven as B Team's Shabazz joins up with Liam's local cricket team. Nothing bad can happen there. Take a look. Boy, did they beat him up. And I will actually travel through time and space to visit Big Brother 3. All will be revealed. Can I have some sort of contrived woo? Yeah, give me a woo. I'm going through time and space. I'm travelling through time. But first, it's time for you viewers to stand up and be counted. It's Little Brother's big shout. Here's how to get in touch. Leon, nail it, buddy. Nice touch. 0871 200 1040 is the phone number. Text studio and your comment to 83188 or email us via that Channel 4 website, channel4.com/BBLB. Last night, we saw Liam call time on his whirlwind romance with Amy, declaring, "Why, I man, I don't want to hurt your feelings." With that in mind, that's exactly how he did it as well. With that in mind, we want to know, Leon, what are your thoughts on Liam and Amy, aka Lamey? There we go. They're touching heads there in a kind of two become one Spice Girls moment. Audience, what are we thinking, by the way, before we go any further? Yeah, you like them. Everyone, is it for real? Are they going to get back together? Who do you like out of the two of them?
Yeah!
So you don't like Ziggy, but you're like, has he done the right thing? Was she using him as part of a game plan?
Yes!
We've got some player haters in tonight, haven't we? Get your texts and emails coming on in, but first we kick off the show, as we always do, Little Brother's Big News. OK. As part of this week's time-travelling shopping task, at 11:48 last night, Big Brother transported the twins back to day two, OK? And the moment they inquired whether they would be one or two housemates. This time, they had to make a decision. Take a look.
If you decide to be treated as one housemate, you will nominate together, be evicted together, and should you win, you will share winner status. But in a twist on nominations, you will definitely face the public vote as one housemate. Should you decide to remain as individuals, you will have to choose one of you to definitely face the public vote. Will you now confirm your decision?
Can you give us a sec?
A.
Oh, we want to be as
one! We're as one! Woo! We're as one! Woo!
Right, this week, me and Amanda are up for a nomination.
What?
But we class as one housemate!
It's not exactly the best news in the world, is it? For eviction, yeah! I felt there was more nomination drama at 2:25 this afternoon after Jonty nominated for the first time. Luckily for him, Carol's ample bosom wasn't too far away.
Oh, are you okay? Oh. Oh, I know. It's a really horrible thing. You're right. No, it is, Jonty. It's a very horrible thing to have to do. Whether you've known people a little while or a long time, it's difficult, but it is one of those sort of processes that we know we've got to do, and it is hard. And the first one of this nature is the hardest, really. It is a show.
Yeah, I think it's like with everybody, doesn't it? Don't get on with
it. I know, I just
give two names, and, you know.
I know.
I mean, I would so much have preferred it if there was somebody really that I didn't get on with. I'd have found that so much easier. I'd say, oh, well, obviously it's so-and-so because I don't like them.
Yeah.
But, you know, there isn't anybody.
No, so well, I mean,
I'm always hoping I'm up, so I don't have to go through that again.
Oh, no.
And back to the bosom, Jonty. At 5:48 this evening, Brian and Cara Louise were the next housemates to do a bit of time travelling. They were transported back to 2002, and Brian was very, very excited about that, where they met some very special guests. Take a look.
You must now exit the time machine and enter the year 2002.
Yeah, 2002. I like 2002. Yeah, 2002.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it's Big Brother 3! Oh, yeah!
Alex and Adele come to the living area.
Shut up! No! No! I want the... Shut up!
Oh, my God!
the bill. I've watched the DVD so many times. I've done all the episodes and video and everything. I've all the episodes.
When you did Behind the Mirror, it was so cool.
Thank you.
Alex looks terrified, doesn't he? I love this show, and I work in a show, and you know, it takes over your whole summer. But Brian has every episode of Big Brother 3 on. What does he do? He comes in and goes, "Oh, that was a long, hard day." Oh, watch day 47 from series. Has he got Big Brother 4 on that video though? That was Little Brother's Big News. Now, today's guests are no strangers to Big Brother after his 12 Diet Cola fueled days in the Celebrity Big Brother house.
How dare you!
I love that. Music to my ears. And their stint presenting Big Mouth. It's now Little Brother's turn to welcome John McCurick, his loyal wife, Booby, and Copper the dog!
Hello, Copper.
Oh, Copper
wanted to bite you the last time.
He wanted to bite the camera.
Go on, bite him. Go on, bite him. Go on, Copper, bite him.
Oh, John, don't do that. Go on, Copper, bite me.
Go on.
Booby, will Copper bite me?
Good dog.
Oh, okay. Now, listen, what are you making of the series so far?
Well, obviously, it's tremendous, as everybody always says. But one thing we have got to do, and where Big Brother has failed, we have got to separate the twins.
Okay.
The only drama will come when they're forced apart. So put them in a separate house, whatever it is. We've got to separate the twins. And that vote tonight was actually bad, bad news. They're going out together. Mm-hmm. So, of course, the betting, a lot of betting goes on this. Yeah. And the exchanges have realised on Betfair, they realised what was going on. And they're into around 7-2 and 5-1, Amanda and Sam, the twins. And there's a lot of opposition now to Brian on the exchanges. He's only around a 6-4 on chance. Brian the Brain to win it.
Well, this is the thing, because I think people obviously have to earn the right to win Big Brother. Mm. Splitting the twins up would really do that.
Of course, but the point is, you've got influence. You know the Big Brother and all the important people. Just go there, use your power and influence and say, we have got to split the twins. Separate the twins. Yeah, make that your campaign.
What do you think?
Separate the twins. Yeah, you want to. No, but isn't it awful, Dermot, what we're going on about the hateful Charlie, the appalling Chanel? Here, the lovely twins, they don't hurt anybody. They're kind, they're laughing, they're gay, they're joyful, etc. And yet we're somehow wanting to split them up and to make them miserable.
Yeah, OK.
And so decent girls are still there, though we have got rid of, course, we got rid of Charlie and Chanel. These are Nicky, these appalling people.
Now, listen, we understand you in particular have a soft spot for Carol, John. Tell us
about. Yeah. Well, Carol is absolutely fantastic. You think of her, and when she went in the house, I thought, well, I'm going to get this one out as fast as I can. A left-winger,
yep.
A social worker,
right up your
for
alley.
Goodness sake, political activist and a demonstrator. You thought,
love all that.
Nothing worse could be imaginable. And how has she turned it round? How would the house operate without her? She does all the cooking. They even had to put boxing gloves on her hands to stop her cleaning at
absolutely.
One time. She's the only one. The young people in this country, as we've seen in the house, are idle. You won't do any housework. You won't do the cooking, the washing up. My Booby does all that. She is the Carol of our house.
Boo the fat pig and take a look at Carol.
Carol, you cannot do any cleaning today.
No, OK. What a great job. I'll tell you what, if I'm unemployed, you can employ me, I'll make a mess any time. Probably clear it up again. But...
Yeah. Carol, you would.
You're always cleaning something.
I have seen her maybe once or twice. But one thing I can say, ooh, she's very nice. She's a lady. What I really want to know. Somehow I've got to let my feelings show. She's fresh, exciting. She's so exciting to me. She's fresh, fresh.
Carol could be no match for the Booby.
Well, she's so bright and incisive, Carol, as well. She's understood the mechanics of the house, the tricks Big Brother was getting under, all the plots that the other housemates were up to. My wife, the Booby, well, she's not as bright as Carol, that's for sure. But
thank
she's
you.
Very, very
thank
good
you.
At cleaning.
Booby.
No, she is. No, she is. No, she's very good at the cleaning. Cleaning.
Give her a pat on the head.
No, but there's one final duty that Carol has got to do. John T has got to be initiated into the ways of the world.
Oh,
you always
come
no,
on,
no,
John.
No, you always always go to an older woman. I did it my own way, you did as well. An older woman who experienced can go and teach
the same
you.
Girl.
So Jonty should be going to Carol. Her last social work ever will be to initiate Jonty.
Bibi, your thoughts on Carol? Do you like her? Because you know, you've been doing
it. She looks after everyone. She's wonderful, isn't she? Mm-hmm. And if they're feeling down, she puts her arm around them, she talks to them, and they must be desperate in there.
Well, the thing is, though, it seems to me, and Carol gets quite irritable about this, the rest of the housemates take her quite for granted.
Excellent. Mm. You're right.
She's been up for eviction weeks 2, 3 and 4.
But ridiculous.
Her up since.
Ridiculous. Mad. But what would they do?
If they lost her, what would they do? Who would do the cooking? Who would do the washing up? They're so bone-idle.
It'll be interesting to see. Audience, yeah. Any chance Carol can win this show?
No!
Do you like Carol?
No!
Don't you like your own mothers?
No.
Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Incredibly harsh audience are going tonight. Housemates nominated this afternoon. Who do you think will be up?
Well, I certainly... Well, now that the twins are up, which is really, really is really bad news, I'd like Ziggy to go. Now, I got sympathy with Ziggy. Ziggy is good-looking. I'm like that myself. All my life, no, I've had the problems that Ziggy has got, that women are easy. They can always get them. They're always after you. I know the problems. So you play one off against the other. You're inclined to exaggerate and tell...
Booby like, up against like, copper, that sort of thing.
No, I've done the same thing myself.
You can't handle this.
And the one woman we're going to save... No, we're going to save is Amy, who does it 4 or 5 times a night, just like the booby, 4 or 5 times a night. We have got to save Amy. She's the totty there. Her chest is fantastic. So save Amy, separate the twins, get rid of Ziggy. That's my
blueprint for a wonderful relationship. John and Booby, everyone. Thank you. And Cop, I'm
sorry. Good
Cop.
Boy. Bite
him.
Go on, bite
him. Team Shabazz. Stumps Liam's cricketing pals, and we take a trip back in time to meet one or two old faces when we ride in Big Brother's amazing time travelling machine. We'll see you in 2.4 light years. Welcome back to Day 69. It's 7:48. Still to come, B-Team Shabazz. It's Liam's friends for six with his unique style of cricket, and we hear your thoughts and views in today's Little Brother's Big Shout. But first, this week's shopping task is designed to make the housemates go where no housemates have ever gone before, travelling back through time. And in a BBLB first, we're going to get in on the action too. Before we do that, yesterday, Carol, Jerry, Tracy and Ziggy travelled back to the year 1847 and faced a series of typically brilliant Victorian tasks. Here's how they got on.
Good day to you, time travellers.
Hi,
welcome to the year 1847.
Hi.
Using the wires provided, time travellers must attempt to create an electrical circuit.
Let's go systematically then.
All good in the hoodeth, sorry.
Your time is now up. Time travellers have failed this part of the task.
No trip in 1847 would be complete without partaking in one of Big Brother's favourite pastimes. Apple bobbing!
It is a monstrosity of a woman now. Mm. Look at that.
This is like a hippopotamus. Immense in her own fat.
Oh, big bit there, I didn't really want.
Time travellers, congratulations.
Yay!
You have managed to successfully bob all of the apples and pass the task.
That's it.
Bye.
What fun.
Thank you.
I'm hungry.
Thank you, Big Brother.
OK, this is very, very exciting. The time has come to enter the Big Brother time machine. Having never travelled through time before, I'm taking no chances, as you can see. It's time to go into the diary room.
Oh, my God.
Jesus. Shut up. No wonder Brian says it all the time. So earlier on, Brian and Carol Louise went back to 2002 to see the housemates of Big Brother 3. And there was a small gap in the time-space continuum, so that's what I'm doing too. Ready? Tell me when to go like that.
Thank you.
Brilliant, brilliant. Okay. Oh, I feel a bit different, slightly younger, better looking. No way. It's like the solar system. This one. Hey, we're back in Big Brother 2002 with Adele and Alex. Hello, guys.
Hi.
How are you? So nice to see you.
You, you look about 4 years older.
Hello, Adele.
It's good to see you.
Wow, this is extraordinary. OK, this must be pretty weird for you, having people from the future visiting you while you're on Big Brother.
Yeah.
They knew all about me as well.
It's extraordinary. Really scary. What's going on? Now, what do you make of our housemates from 2007, even though you don't really know them?
Well, one of them definitely likes cider. I've noticed that. He's talking about cider the whole time, you know. But yeah, Brian, I like him very much. He seemed to know a lot about me. It was really freaky.
He has. In the future.
He told me about things I haven't even done yet, you know.
He has every episode of the show you were on back in 2002 on videotape.
I know. Really? I know what I'm going to do now in 3 weeks.
Now, being as though you're in 2002, having never seen any of the Big Brother eight housemates before, who would you like to win the series?
Brian.
Yeah?
Yeah, he's wicked.
Definitely. I think so. Yeah.
How do you know? You've just met him.
No, it's just the vibe, Dermot, the vibe. Mm.
And are you surprised that Big Brother's, like, had eight series, seeing as though Big Brother 4 was a bit of a stinker, even though you haven't seen that yet?
Well, I'm more surprised about the time travel. I didn't really... I thought it was going to happen in about 10 years' time, not so soon.
And it's amazing that Big Brother was the organisation that actually founded it.
Yeah.
You like this?
Yeah, I do.
So you're checking
it
out there, Al.
I'm never going to look at my funnel again the same way, you know?
OK, listen, that's pretty much it. Thank you ever so much.
Thank you.
It's very, very nice for you to join us. Just some info from the future. Neither of you win. Kate does. Alex, you do...
What?
You do a
I didn't win?
You do a cleaning commercial,
man.
But you finish fourth. Adele, you're still a DJ, you finish seventh. Jay goes on to earn millions, then goes back into Celebrity Big Brother, which is a big mistake. And in that same series, H from Steps comes out as gay. Anyway, I'm being told...
He's gay.
I know. I'm being told the space hole is starting to close.
I just thought he was left-handed.
So I need to go, all right. It's nice to see you.
Thank you.
Nice to see you. Take care. Cheers, guys, for being such great sports. Now, this summer, Liam's cricket team have been without his playing services for obvious reasons, so feeling guilty, we offered to fill that missing place with a player of outstanding talent and all-rounder with great ball skills. We sent B-Team's Shabazz. Here's some Big Brother 7. Don't even go there.
Today, I'm at Lanchester Cricket Club, taking Liam's place. Yes, I'm here to play cricket! How do you think he's doing in the house?
Oh, very well. Very well. We're all delighted.
He's doing Lanchester proud. Oh, he's performing really well in the house. We're all proud of him from the village and especially from the cricket club.
I don't think his true self has come out yet. There's still more to come.
I think you'll win it, like.
Nice shot.
What do you think of his relationship with Amy?
With who?
Well, he is a bit of a ladies' man, as people are aware.
It was just a matter of time. As soon as there was a little bit of something in there for him to get a hold of, he'd be straight in there.
I think they're both playing a game, and I think Liam's playing it very well.
Hi-da! Would you like to give a message to Liam's fans right down there?
Well, I would just like to say, ensure that you don't give him the chop.
Liam, I think your place on the cricket team is secure. Back to you, in the studio.
Well, we are back here in 2007. Oh, I feel haggard. With John the Booby and, of course, Copper. For today's big shout, earlier we asked you your thoughts on Liam and Amy, a.k.a. Lamey. Let's go straight to the web caller, I think. Karen in Reading. Hey, Karen in Reading.
Hi, Dana.
How are you?
I'm very well, how are you?
Yeah, I'm not bad. What do you think, then, about Lamey?
Well, I think that they do both actually like each other.
Yeah.
But I think Liam's a bit worried because no one else in the house seems to like Amy.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Liam knows that he's quite popular in the house. So that's why he's trying to call it off with her, so he doesn't, like, bring down his house status by being with her.
John and the booby, is Liam playing Amy, do you think?
He's worried about his image. Mm. He suddenly realises, I'm going very, very well, suddenly, 4 days with this, the public will be turning on me.
Yeah.
But he does fancy she is a right bit of totty. 4 or 5 times a night, my goodness, she's equal to the booby. So I'm saying, clearly, he wants to sort of get back with her, but he's frightened of losing another 100 grand. He's picked up 100 grand already.
Well, he's certainly, he's one of the favourites, isn't he, you'd say, Liam? And people seem to like him. Karen, thanks a lot for that.
Thank you.
Take care. Bye. Does she live underwater? Next up is Kath in Shrewsbury, I believe, on the phone. Hello, Kath.
Hi, Dermot.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Lamey, what's your thoughts?
I think she's a gold digger, Dermot.
Oh, why?
He's a gold digger.
He's straight through her like a pane of glass.
Oh, he's got the money.
Yes.
Go on then, my love. Say, what's
well,
your...
Well, she knew exactly... Liam had 100,000. He's got 100,000 sitting there, and she knew exactly what she's doing.
So she's thinking, oh, I fancy a bit of that Liam, and I fancy a bit of the
of the money,
Spondooli as well.
Of the money. Mm-hmm.
No, no one do anything that see through, would they?
Yeah.
Oh my God, all the girls in the audience are nodding.
No, but will the public vote against Liam, realising he's got £100,000? Mm. Does he need more? For that reason, is he in trouble with the public?
Yeah. Okay. It's a good point. Thanks a lot, there, Kath. Milk, is that you or Mick?
Mick.
Hello, Mick. Be brilliant if you were called Milk. Milk from Norwich. What's your point, Milk?
I think that he's not going to be able to resist her for much longer.
No.
He's got an emotional age of about 16. That's why he likes to play with the twins so much. Mm. And but, of course, Carol's got everybody thinking that they need her permission. So he's worried about that. I think he'll go ahead, though, because he's got that little glint in his eye.
I have to ask you, though, Milk, could you resist Amy yourself if you were given the chance?
Well, I'm 61 years old, and I couldn't. And I still couldn't, know.
Brilliant stuff. Thanks a lot, Milk. Take care.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. That is it for tonight. Thanks to all our guests. We are back tomorrow, 7.30 on E4, with live reveal and nominations. Catch up with all the latest house action from tonight. 10 o'clock, Channel 4. We will be seeing you tomorrow. Thanks a lot, John. Thanks a lot, Phoebe. Thanks a lot, Copper. Take care.